Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Homain TV. Today we're going to talk about creating or modifying tempo markings in Dorico. If you're new to the channel or new to Dorico tutorials, please make sure to check the other videos as they can give you a better insight into Dorico. Link will be in the description below. Let's start. So upon opening a project in Dorico, you can access the tempo markings by going to the right panel, so over here, and then you have multiple options here. I'll talk about them in detail, but first let's see the options. The first one we have is tap tempo, then we have absolute tempo change. We go down, we have gradual tempo change and relative tempo change, reset tempo, and finally tempo equation. Now let's go back up. The first one allows you to use the tap button to figure out your tempo in real time. Let's try it out. So I'm going to start clicking on this tap here, tap button. As you can see, the BPM counter is changing. Once I am happy with the number, then I can specify my beat unit by clicking on these buttons. So for example, I want to say it's a quarter, or I want to say it's a eighth note dotted, but now I want to say it's just a quarter. And then I click create. And as you can see, I have my tempo marking on top of my time signature. Of course, that works if you are highlighting somewhere and you just click create, but if you're not highlighting anything in your score, you can also just press create and then grab it. And it's really small, but you can see it, it's in white. You can just grab it and put it anywhere you want. Next is absolute tempo changes. As you notice, there is a long list of tempo markings here, which you can simply click on and you can put them wherever you want. So it's the same as above. But now take a look here. There is a long list here, which are the recommendations that Dorico have for you with these names. If you didn't find the tempo that you want here, you can easily use this slider up here to just add them here. So for example, I was looking for faster tempos and I'm gonna say, okay, just show me the higher numbers here with this slider. And as you can see, we have the maximum speeds here too. And I just click, and as you can see, it's changed. And as usual, another way of adding or changing stuff in Dorico is using the popover. So what we can do is that, first I'm gonna delete these guys. What I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna add a tempo here, so I'm gonna use the popover, Shift T for tempo, and I can just type in my tempo marking. For example, I can write a text, adagio, and go down, or I can also just write a number, so Shift T, Q equals 40. Super neat. And now back to the list. So after our absolute tempo changes, we have gradual tempo change. And it works the same as the options above. However, you can also use Poco and Moto here. So you can just click on Poco and whoop. Make sure nothing is highlighted actually, because now it didn't work. So I'm gonna click on Poco and then Calando. And as you can see, I have Calando already hanging from my mouse cursor, and I just click and you have Poco Calando here, and it works with the Moto as well. Now let's go a little bit down. Then we have the relative ones and they work the same as with above. And also don't forget that you can invoke, I think all of these, you can invoke the popover and use them from the popover. So let's just try, if I say Shift D Stretto, yes. It works super nice, and Stretto is also here. And then you have the reset tempos right here, tempo primo and tempo secondo and other stuff. And finally, you have the tempo equation, which is quite self-explanatory, but you can just easily select the equation that you want and change it. And before we get to the next part, I wanted to kindly ask that if you are enjoying this video, please make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel for a lot of different videos and tutorials about music. Super thanks. All right, so let's continue. As with everything in Dorico, you always have extra options to customize stuff. Let's see what I'm talking about. For this page and this part of the tutorial, I added one tempo marking from each category in the right panel. And each one has slightly different options to modify, and in order to see the different settings and options, I will open the lower panel by clicking on it. And if I now highlight any of the tempo markings in my score, you can see the options are changing. Now let's start with the first one. I'm going to click on Andante here. Now you have a bunch of different options here. So the first one gives you the ability to modify the text. The second one gives you the ability to add an abbreviation. So for example, you can do if you need it. And as you can see on top, the name has changed. The next one is a button for the abbreviation. So you can either have it or remove the abbreviation. Then you have the actual tempo so that you can change the BPM here. If I change it to 90 and above, also the score has changed. Then you have the beat unit, which you can also change. And if you see it up there, it's changing. Onto the right side, you have the text shown, which lets you hide or show the text of your tempo marking. Then you have metronome mark known, metronome mark shown, and which is quite self-explanatory. You have parenthesize option, which gives you the parentheses here, and you have the approximate sign, which you can, if you enable it, you get a new option set here, and you can just choose whatever you want. So I can put circa. And look in the score, it has changed. And the next one is, you can also remove your equal sign. Then you can also, let's see, yeah, you have the tempo range here. Let's say I want my tempo to be from 72 to 90. 90 was my original tempo, which is set here. And then I added another one to say, okay, this tempo is 70 to 90. The next one is your metronome mark order, which you can just, it's just a switch and you can see what's doing with the appearance. Now let's check the other stuff. This is a gradual one. And as you can see, there's also this tiny line that you can hold. And if you want to move it, you can also use this. Super nice. So these are self-explanatory. I already told you guys, the only different thing here is you have poco a poco here, which adds a poco a poco. You have the final tempo. This is actually a cool thing here. So imagine your tempo is starting from here and it's 100 BPM. And you have the calando that is going from this point to this point. This says that if you put a calando here and the final tempo is 50%, then if it starts 100 here, 100 BPM, it's gonna be 50 BPM here by the end of your calando symbol. But if you pull it till here or anywhere else, well, you have some other stuff that's not, it's not going, then it will be 50 here. So it's, you can just stretch how fast or slow this goes to 50%. And then you have an option to change the initial tempo, which is also cool. And this is basically says that once the music gets to this point, your tempo will be the value below. So for example, before this, your tempo is 60 continuously, and then suddenly the tempo will jump to 120, and then it will go back to 60 here. So it's just a spike in tempo here. And you have the gradual style. You can change it here. You can say, hey, I want it to be like RIT triple dot, which this doesn't have that. But let's just say I'm gonna put this one, yeah. Okay, check this out. I'm gonna put the gradual style. Yeah, so first is RIT just dot that the ritenuto. The next one gives you the tiny dots, and the other one is just a long name. And then finally, you have the line style here, which is dotted, dashed, or other stuff, but it's really tiny. You cannot see it, but I'm going to change this to ritenuto. Ah, yeah, you can see it now. Okay. And then let's move to the other one. This one goes into the relative tempo changes, and this is also self-explanatory. The only option here is this, how much the tempo is going to go. So it's like relative percent to 100%. So if it's 100 at this point, it's going to be 200, and there's a text shown or hide option here. Then you have tempo primo, which there is no extra option in there. And then finally you have the tempo equation, which it's just a parenthesis here and the text shown. And that was it, everyone. I hope that you enjoyed this video. And next video, I will be talking about dynamics. And if you like this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Hope to see you soon, and till later. Bye.